How's it going, everybody? It's your bro, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys a little bit about method chaining in Java, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. One like equals one prayer for the YouTube algorithm. Alright, welcome back guys and gals. In this video we're going to discuss method chaining. This is a common syntax for invoking multiple method calls in object-oriented programming. That's the definition I found on Wikipedia. This is useful for condensing code into less lines. So let's create an object. A string is a type of object. Let's say string name equals bro, all lowercase. You can use your own name if you want. We can perform multiple methods on this variable name. Let's begin by concatenating our name with another name, maybe your last name. Name equals name dot, and let's use the concat method. And I'm going to concatenate another string with our variable of name. And I'll just add code to this. And let's display our name. System.out.println name. And my result is bro code. So let's perform another method on this name for this example. Name equals name dot. What do we got here? How about two uppercase? So this will make my name all uppercase. So everything is all caps. And let's perform one more method. Name equals name dot. Let me find a good one. Trim, that's good. So trim will remove any blank space before and after a string. So I'll add a few spaces before and after my string. And this will remove these blank spaces. Currently, this program is taking up 3 lines of code to call 3 separate methods. To condense this into less lines of code, we can perform a little bit of method chaining. So what I'm going to do is turn these 3 lines into comments for now, and we will condense all of these 3 methods into one using some method chaining. So let's begin by reassigning our name variable, name equals, and then we'll begin with name.concat. Instead of adding the semicolon at the end, I'm going to follow this with another dot, and then I can call another method right away. This time I'm going to call the toUpperCase method. And then why stop there? I will follow this with another dot and use my trim method next. So where is it? There it is. So this is name.concat dot toUpperCase dot trim, and then add the semicolon at the end. So we're combining all 3 method calls into one so that this takes up 1 line of code. It's like a 3-hit combo. Boom, boom, boom. So even though we have written this in less lines of code, it is a little more difficult to read and understand, especially if you're a beginner, but I thought I would mention this because this is probably something that you will see one day, this particular phenomenon. So if you would like a copy of all this code, I will post all of this in the comments down below, and please be sure to drop a like, leave a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.